If 12 mangoes cost rupees 36, what is the price of one mango? A notebook costs rupees 2.40. What is the cost of 5 such notebooks? 126 pages of a book were read in 7 hours. At this rate, how many pages can be read in 12 hours? Okay? Such type of problems, when we see such type of problems, immediately we remember given for one, asking for many, given for many, asking for one. See the first problem. If 12 mangoes are cost rupees 36, if 12 mangoes cost rupees 36, what is the cost or price of one mango? Given for, this is given, cost of 36 is for 12 mangoes. Given for many, this problem, in this problem there is given for many and asking. What asking is question, what is the price of one mango and asking for one. So in this case, when there is given for many and asking for one, we have to find cost of one or anything of for one article, which operation we do? We perform division, correct? We perform division. See the second problem. A notebook costs rupees 2.40. What is the cost of 5 such notebooks? Given, this is given, cost of how many notebooks are given, or how cost of how many notebook is given? Cost of a notebook. A means one. Given for one. Given for one. And asking for what is the cost of 5 such notebooks. 5 means many. Comes under many. So asking for many, given for one, asking for many. And when in this condition, in this case, which operation we perform to find the value of many? When there is given for one and asking for many, which operation do we perform? We perform multiplication, right? So these two cases, the examples which comes under these two conditions, we know how to solve. Okay? There is another one condition, another one case, we can say. See, what is that? Here 126 pages of a book. 126 pages of a book were read in 7 hours. Means 126 pages of book were read in 7 hours. At this rate, how many pages can be read in 12 hours? Here see, this 126 pages read in 7 hours. Then 7 means not 1, it is many. So given for many and at this rate, how many pages can be read in 12 hours? Asking also, see, asking for 12 hours, given for 7 hours, asking for 12 hours. That means in 7 hours, 126 pages can be read. Then in 12 hours, how many pages can be read? So does this example come under any one of these? No. Here, asking for given for many and asking for also many. Given for 7 hours, that is given for many and asking also many, asking for also many. Okay, so in this case, when there is given for many and as well as asking for also many, then in this case, how to find the answer? Which operations should be performed and how to solve? So this third conditions comes under unitary method. What is this unitary method? That this type of examples we are going to solve today in this chapter 9, unitary method. Okay. First two conditions we know, we have solved many examples like this. When there was given for many asking for one, we perform division. When there was given for one asking for many, we perform multiplication. But what is this? Given for many, asking for also many. So how to solve like these examples, that we are going to learn under this unitary method. Okay. Hello everyone, welcome for today's video lecture of Ganit Pravinya. Today, in today's lecture, we are going to learn the next chapter, chapter number 9, whose name is unitary method. So what is mean by unitary method? See, unitary method, you know, unitary, let's split the word unitary, in this word there is word unit which represent for one, you know, units place, we have seen units in number system, we have seen units place or ones place, that means what? Unit means one. Okay, so whenever there is given for many and asking for also many, in that case we have to use unitary method. Means first we have to find value of one. Okay, see, when there is given for many and asking for also many, given for many, asking for many, in that case first what we have to do, this is one condition, these are two different conditions. To reach in this condition, first we have to pass through the unit, that means what? One. So from this, when there is given for many, first we have to find the value of one. We know in the three previous conditions I showed you, in that the first one was given for many, asking for one. Okay, same we have to do that first. Here given for many is there. So from this many, first we will find value of unit, value of one. Okay, and to do that, which operation we perform? Division. When there is given for many and asking for one, we have to do division. Okay, and from when we will get value of one, from this one we will find value of many. So there are two parts, given for many. So from this given for many, first we will find value of one, and for that we will do division. And once we get value of one, from this value of one we will find value of many, and for that we will do multiplication. Okay, so in this case, when there is given for many and asking for also many, we have to perform both the operations, division and multiplication. Understood? That those two conditions are linked with the unit one, so it is called unitary method. Okay, from given for many, using division we will find value of one, and from this value of one, using multiplication, we will find value of many. So this unitary method means, or this type of condition is means what? It is combination of both the first two conditions. It is combination of both first two conditions. Okay, so we will use both the conditions, given for many, asking for one, and given for one, asking for many. Okay, so be ready for the exercise 16. First example of exercise 16 is, see here, open your book, page number 115. First five examples we will learn in this lecture. See the first. A laborer takes 1 hour 30 minutes for cleaning 6 rooms. A laborer takes 1 hour 30 minutes for cleaning 6 rooms. How much time will be required to clean 16 such rooms? So what is given here? See, what is given? Time required to clean 6 rooms. Time required to clean six rooms. Okay. How much time is required to clean six rooms? 1 hour 30 minutes. So see, whenever time is given in hour and minute, or minute and second, whatever, if two units are there, first we will convert that time into only one unit. That is, last one unit will convert hour into minute, and this 30 minutes we will add in that. You know, 1 hour means how many minutes? 60 minutes. Plus this 30 minutes. Total how many minutes are there? 90 minutes. So to clean 6 rooms, time required to clean 6 rooms, how much? 90 minutes. This is given. What is asked? And asking what? Time required to clean 16 search rooms. Time required to clean 16 search rooms. Search means same. 1 BHK, okay? What? So see here, given. This is given for 6 rooms. It is also many. And asking for 16 search rooms. It is also many. Given for many, asking for many. Third condition. Okay? So in this case, we have to use unitary method. So first we will find, with the given, first we will find time required to clean one room. See, let's find time required to clean one room. Okay. This, from here you will start to find the answer. Let's find first time required to clean one room. You know, we know that time required to clean 6 rooms is 90 minutes. Okay? So, the time required to clean one room is what? To find that required to clean one room, which operation we are going to do? Yes, we are going to do division. That is, 90 minutes we will divide among 6 rooms. So, we will get the time required to clean each of 6 rooms, okay? So 90 divided by 6. You know, 90 divided by 6, what answer? You can do on rough page. 90 divided by 6. 6 1 the 6, 3 remain, 0 came down, 6 5 the 30, 15. So 15 minutes are required to clean one room. So here we have found one, means what? We have crossed the first condition. We have used here division to find value of one. Now using this value of one, we will find many, that is 16. Okay? So time required to clean 16 search rooms is equal to, okay, now we have value of 1. Now we have value of 1, that is 15. So using the value of 1, we will find many. When asking, given for 1, asking for many, which operation we do? We do multiplication. So you see, 16 rooms multiply by 15 minutes. That is 16 into 15. 240. So 240 minutes are required. 240 minutes, again, if the answer is asked into hours, then we need to convert this minute into hours. You know how to convert minutes into hours? Yes, you know, 1 hour means, or 1 hour means 60 minutes. So to convert this minute into hours, let's divide this by 60. Okay, or here you can do this also, 60. 0, 0 cut, 6, 4, 6, 1, 6, 6, 4, 24. That is 4 hours. So 240 minutes means 4 hours. Okay, so time required to clean 16 such rooms is 4 hours. Okay, time required to clean 6 rooms is 1 hour 30 minutes. And so time required to clean 16 such rooms is 4 hours. In this way, we have to find the answer when in this condition, when there is given for many and asking also for many. Okay, first find the value of 1, then find the value of many. Pause this video, write this in your notebook. Second problem. A train covers a distance of 135 km in 3 hours. In 3 hours, the train covers the distance of 135 km. How much distance will it cover in 7 hours? So what is given? Distance covered by train. Distance covered by train in 3 hours. The distance covered by train in 3 hours is given. What is that? 135 km. And what is asked? The distance covered by train. Distance covered by train Distance covered by train in how many hours? 7 hours. That you have to find. Okay? Once you pick out what is given and what is asked, then you can decide whether it is the example come in the first condition, second condition, or second condition is given for one, asking for many. And third condition is given for many, asking for many. Okay? So in this condition, we have to use unitary method, means let's find first the distance covered by train in 1 hour. Okay, distance covered by train in 1 hour we will find first. For that we will use the first given. See, in 3 hours it covers 135 km distance. Then in 1 hour, for that when there is given for many, asking for one, which operation we perform? Division, that is 135 divided by 3. So 135 divided by 3, 3 4s are 12. 1 carry forward 15, 3 5s are 15, 45 km. So the train covers 45 km distance in 1 hour. As it covers 135 km in 3 hours, so 45 km in 1 hour. We have divided first, okay? First part is division. And using division we will find value of 1. And using that value of 1, let's find value of many. So distance covered by train in 7 hours is, now in 1 hour it covers 45 km, so in 7 hours means given for one, asking for many. Second condition, second part, where we have to do multiplication. So 45 kilometer multiplied by 7, that is 7 5s are 35, 3 will be carried, 7 4s are 28, 28 plus 3, 31, 315 kilometer. So in 7 hours, that train covered 315 kilometer distance. Okay, again see here. Here was given for many, asking for also many. So first using division, we found the distance covered by train in 1 hour. And using that distance covered in 1 hour, we found the distance covered in 7 hours. There we used multiplication. Okay? Pause this video, write this in your notebook. Find the cost of 4 pencils. Find the cost of 4 pencils at rupees 11.40 per dozen. Per dozen means Doesn't mean how many pencil? 12 pencils, okay? So, cost of, what is given? Cost of a dozen pencils. And a dozen means not one pencil, it is a dozen means 12 pencils, okay? What is that? Rupees 11.40. Rupees 11.40. This is cost of a dozen pencils, means 12 pencils. Okay. And what is asked? Cost of, find the cost of 4 pencils. And we have to find cost of only 4 pencils. Okay. That means given for 12. And asking for 4. That means given for many, asking for many. So first, let's find the cost of one pencil. Cost of one pencil. And to find cost of one pencil, we will find divide the total cost of 12 pencils by 12. So rupees 11.40 divided by 12. This cost of 12 pencils we will divide by 12 pencils. So that we will get cost of 1 pencil. Okay. Now here see division of decimal. Now you know how to divide decimal. First convert this into common fraction. For some time forget this rupee sign. At the end we will write in the answer. 11.40. If you want to convert into common fraction, then 1140 upon what? 1000, 1000 what? Right, 1 after decimal point, 2 digits are there, so 2 zeros. Divide by 12. 12 as denominator 1, okay? Now, 1140 upon 100. Division of fraction. Division of fraction is nothing but multiplication by its reciprocal. That is multiply by reciprocal of 12 upon 1, 1 upon 12. Okay? Now let's divide into 1 upon 100 into 12. So now see this 1140 and 12 are divisible by, means 1140 is divisible by 12. See 12 nines are 108. 140 minus 108, 6 remain. 12, 5 is 60, 95. 12, 1 is 12, 12, 95 is. Okay? So 95 upon 100. 95 upon 100. Okay? Now this 95, we will convert in. We will divide 95 by 100. See, 95 divided by 100. What we will get? When there is division by 100, what to do? Put decimal point before 2 digits in the numerator. So here there are only 2 digits, so decimal point will come here and 95 means 0.95. Okay, 95 upon 100 means 0.95. So 0.95 rupees 0.95 is the cost of one pencil. Rupees 0.95 is the cost of one pencil, and we have to find now. So, cost of how many pencils? 4 pencils we have to find. So, cost of 4 pencils is equal to rupees. We'll multiply this cost of one pencil by 4. 0.95 into 4. So, it will be 4 5s are 20, 2 carry, 4 9s are 36 plus 2, 38, 3 carry, 4 0s are 0 plus 3, 3. And where decimal point will come? Before 2 digits, right? Here after decimal point, 2 digits are there. So, decimal point will come before 2 digits. That is, cost of 4 pencils is rupees 3.80, 3 rupees 80 paise. Okay? Write this in your notebook. See fourth one. The cost of 7 quintals of wheat is ₹4,935. Find the cost of 427 kg of wheat at the same rate. So given is cost of 7 quintal of wheat is ₹4,935. 4,935 is the cost of 7 quintal wheat. Now, and ask what is asked? Cost of 427 kilogram rice in wheat. Cost of 727 kg wheat is what? So see, given, it is given in a quintal, the wheat, cost of wheat which is given, it is given in quintal and asked in kilogram. So first, we will convert this quintal into kilogram. You know, 1 quintal means how many kilogram? 1 quintal means 100 kg. Correct? We have seen in previous chapter. So 7 quintal is equal to 700 kg. Okay? So this is cost of actually 700 kg wheat. Okay? So first we will find, let's find the cost of 1 kg wheat. So once we will get cost of 1 kg wheat, we can find cost of 727 kg wheat. Okay. So to find cost of 1 kg wheat, what we have to do? We have to divide cost of 700 kg wheat. That is, we have to divide 4935 by 700. Okay. So 4935 divided by 700 is equal to, now see, both 4935 and 700 are divisible by, they are divisible by 7. If you check, see, 4935, 700 is divisible by 7, confirm, but let's check this. 77 is 49, 0, 3 came down, 0 is 0, 5 came down, 35, 7, 5 is 35. Is it divisible? Yes. And 700 is obviously 107 is 700, okay? So both are divisible by 7. 700 divided by 7, 100. And 4935 divided by 7, 705. Okay, so we have 705 upon 100. So 705 divided by 100, what answer you will get? Where to put decimal point? From last, before two digits, 7.05. So cost of 1 kilogram wheat, cost of 1 kilogram wheat is ₹7.05. So 7, that is 7 rupees 5 paise. Okay, and now we have to find cost of 727 kg rice wheat. So cost of 727 kilogram wheat is equal to 727 multiplied by this 7.05. Okay, see here, let's multiply here, 727 multiply by, forget decimal point first, 705. 1 minute, it is, sorry, it is 427, not 727, it is 427. Okay, so multiply by 427 multiply by 705. Forget decimal point first. 5 7s are 35. We will be carried. 5 2s are 2. 5 2s are 10. 10 plus 3 13. 3 will come down. 1 will be carried. 5 4s are 20 plus 1 21. put 0 in the ones place. 07s are 0, 02s are 0, 04s are 0. Put 2 zeros, 77s are 49, 4 carry, 72s are 14, 14 plus 4, 18, 8 will come down, 1 carry, 7, 4s are 28 and 1, 29. 5, 3, 9 and 1, 10, 1 carry, 8 plus 2, 10 and 1, 11, 1 carry. 9 plus 1, 10, 3. Okay? So answer is 301035. And where to put decimal point? Where to put decimal point? Here. After, after decimal points, your two digits are there. That means in answer, before we have to put decimal point from backside before two digits. So it is cost of 427 kilogram wheat is rupees 3010.35. That is 3010 rupees and 35 paise. Understood? Pause this video, write in your notebook. See fifth one. The wages of 6 mason for a week are rupees 726. Wages of 6 mason for a week is rupees 756, okay? And what will be the wages of 6 mason? What will be the wages of 15 mason? 15 masons for weekly means for a week. Means what? In 1 week, 6 masons have to give rupees 756 as a wages, or 6 masons are given rupees 756 as a wages. Wages means, mason means what? Labor, okay? And wages means their daily income, okay? Daily rupees, what they have to pay. So now they are getting rupees 756 in a week, okay? 6 mason. Then in a week, 15 mason, how many rupees they will get? Okay. So first let's find the wages of 1 mason for a week. Means in 1 week, 1 mason how much rupees earn? Okay. So for that we will divide rupees 756 divided by 6 mason. So 756 divided by 6. 6 1s are 6. 15, then 6 2s are 12. 6 6 are 36. 1 26. 6 6 are 36, right? So 126 rupees. 126 rupees in 1 week. So wages of 15 mason for a week will be 126 multiplied by 15. Okay, rupees 126, which is the wages of 1 mason for a week, we will multiply that by 15, okay? So 15 6 are 90, 9 will be carried, 15 2 are 30 plus 9, 39, 3 will be carried, 15 1 are 15 plus 3, 18, rupees 1890, this is the wages of 15 mesons for a week, okay? Here we found first value of 1, and using that value of 1, we have found value of min. Okay, so in this way we have to use unitary method when there is the condition given for many and asking for also many. First we have to find the value of unit, that is 1, and using the value of 1 we have to find value of many. And you know, to find value of 1 we use division, okay, and to find value of many we use multiplication. So both the operations we have to use in this condition. Okay, so I hope you have understood today's lecture. If you have any doubt in this, ask me during doubt session. So thank you for today and have a nice day.